There's the 2014 Dodge Caravan 30th anniversary. This is my winter car and my road trip partner right here. I like these vans. I just changed the front brakes on it. It's got 90 some thousand miles on it. It's getting a little bit of wobble in the front, and that was from overheating brakes, and I don't know when they were changed last, so I went ahead and put some new ones on the front. I'll do the rear when I get a chance too. They're fine right now, but I'll do that too. I don't want to spend too much time, but I usually get about 25 to 27 miles to the gallon on the highway on it, and I drive fairly fast. It's got a lot of room in it. When I built this bed, this little bed that comes in and out of here, I want to build it that one seat is always up in the back, one of the smaller seats on the side, second row, or rear second row, excuse me, the smaller one, not the double seat. So I want it so it fit perfectly. So the pieces of wood I showed earlier, I measured them 30 inches wide by 78 or 79 inches length. So I'm 6 foot, so plenty of room for me. I might cut a little bit off the end, it just all depends. But how I want to try and set it up is use both pieces of wood, which are the same exact height, and put them together, maybe put hinges on them where one folds on top of the other. And then when I have my spouse and my kid with me, and this is something for me to do too. It can fold when they're with me, I can unfold it and use it as a full platform. But when they're not with me, you know, it's just a single. So anyway, too much time. That's the 2014 Dodge Caravan. Pretty good van. I like it. Good horsepower for my backup car. Never no problems on mountains or anything like that. Parts are plenty for these cars. I think they've been making this version since 2008, 2009. They just finally stopped making them like last year for the Chrysler Pacific. Anyway, let's get in.
There's a quick picture video of the inside of it. As you can see, I want to keep the rear seat. There's two in the front, two in the middle, and three in the back. So the bigger one's been put away. I leave the small one, that's for my son, who's like 11. He fits fine in there. So that's how I want to do it. So I want to put the bed frame right there. I might make it a little bit more narrow, but like I said, I want to make it so it folds over to make a single, but when my kid and my spouse is with me, it folds out for a full, if that makes sense to everybody. That's what I want to do. And then when we're also traveling, it folds back over and you got plenty of room. And I also carry on the back on the tow hitch right down there. It's not on there right now. But I have a platform where I keep a lot of my supplies on the outside. And that's just how it's gonna go. So that's what I'm gonna go for. I'm no carpenter, not my trade, but I do know a little bit. So let's see if we got.
See, I cut three parts. I might reinforce it some more, but I wanna start with doing it like this. So there's the three different with the legs and the support. All right, as you can see, I made three supports for, I can make more if I need to. I'll try it first with that. So basically I just put them together. I use brackets and screw through the end. I use whatever I had on hand. I had a bunch of different types of brackets I had that probably needed to be used up anyway. So I used those to support it and they're pretty firm and everything. So we're gonna go ahead and turn it over, sit it on top of it and start screwing it down, see how it goes. All right. All right, so I put the legs on it, three screws on each support. I'm probably got more, but I might start splitting the wood too. Seems pretty sturdy. If I need any more support, I'll put some more on it too. All right, so there it is inside. I haven't put anything on it yet. I just wanted to fit it in there. So as you know, it's gonna be slumping forward. So either I can cut down the back legs or what I can do is just make a piece of wood or something to lift the front legs to even it out. That's not really that hard to do, you know. So either cut the back legs or, like I said, put something underneath the front legs to level it out. Fit that, the part up by the seat, I'll cut that, I'll round that because you'd easily whack your leg, your knee or your shin on it. So that's what I'll do. What I did was I basically just took some grocery bags material. It's like a roll you get, it's like a few bucks at Walmart. I had one left and I just threw it over the top, a couple staples in it. I will never be laying on exactly this. There's a pad or a small 4-inch foam pad that's going to be coming. So that, of course, will sit on top of this, but something, you know, the rough edges and all that to put on it. So anyway, it was a few bucks, and what it is grocery bag material. And that's exactly what it is. Nothing more, nothing less. All right, Frugal Panda here. I just wanted to show you, this is just a mock showing kind of how it looks in there. I got to do a little bit more reinforcement. It's fine the way it is, but I got to put a little bit, another piece of wood on the middle piece just because the legs are off the ground, which ain't a big deal. I just drill another piece of 2x4 on the bottom of it. And of course, I'm not sleeping on a piece of wood. I just wanted to show you kind of how it looks. I have a trifold mattress coming, and I'll do a review of it once I get it. So it's a trifold that goes on there. It's 4 inches thick. Now, before I go around and show you, just to remind you, on the back of this hitch, even though that's in there over here against the wall, I have a hitch carrier. So a lot of my stuff always goes in a hitch carrier. I have a huge box that I keep a lot of my stuff in it, like pots, pans, stuff like that. I'm not going to use as much tarps. All that stuff will go right on the hitch. So as you can see, if we look underneath it, there's a lot of room. I made it where the seat can sit up in the back if you want to sit in the back. And what I plan to do, I have another piece of wood like this, is put some hinges on it and make it where it flips over, so when I take my kids and my spouse with me, I can have a double or whatever. I got an 11-year-old. So to close up this way, when it's just me, but when I'm taking everybody, it flips over more and it'll go all over there and that seat'll drop. So that's the plan right there. So let's go around real quick. As you can see, the seat's right there, right? I have my Setpower refrigerator freezer. I only use it on refrigerator. It'll be plugged into a Jackery, I'll show in a minute. And I have a solar panel that I can use too, so it's not a big deal. I have all that. And it, the 240 does pretty really well when it's on eco mode. I have 2 rechargeable fans. The little one blasts a lot of air. I actually have 2 of those, technically. One's in the house. I sleep by it. So I can tell you those are actually really good. I've had them for over a year. The other one, and I use it nightly. Takes 1 rechargeable battery. That's it. And charge off my Jackery and everything like that. The other one's pretty decent, too. It lasts a while, but the little one's my favorite. Plus, I can plug in my Jackery, too. It doesn't take hardly any examples. I don't take all this. But that's just to show you, I have a crate right there. I have a thing of a 5-gallon water right there, which I would take. And I had to make sure it was high enough to fit my toilet, just in case I needed it. And right now, I just have the Jackery right here. I'll put it somewhere else. Maybe pop it right in here, you know? I don't know. That little Jackery does really well. See, I'll keep a blanket over just to keep everything covered up. And also, over there in the corner, I have a little light that I can use. Have it forever. There's the seat. The seat sits up easy, and it drops down, too, without you having to move the bed. Speaking of lights, I have that one light. I have plenty more lights if I really want to hang. I'm trying to hold if I decide to upgrade to, like, a Sprinter or Chevy Express for my travel vehicle. So I don't want to hang up my LED lights in here yet. I also have covers for the windows, if you see them. I have them for the front, those, the other side windows. And then I have a curtain that goes across, actually. And then I also have a silver reflective for the windshield if I need it. You can see there's plenty of room, especially if you're by yourself in a Dodge Caravan, you know. I just want to do really just a mock run to put stuff in here, and I realize how much I don't really take, but that cargo carrier I have that goes down there, I put a lock on it too, by the way, takes so much stuff actually outside of the van when I'm traveling, especially by myself, because the only thing else that's really going to go in here is, that thing sitting in the back right here that I got my stuff in, I'll probably get a better one than that one. It's a little more compact. I don't really like that one, to be honest with you. Oh, and up on here, too, is I always have my emergency charger that can jumpstart my car, but also it acts as a light everester. It's a light, it can trip USBs on it. It actually has pretty good juice in it. That was a good buy, it works flawlessly. So I use that. So, but as you can see, there's quite a bit of room to pack a ton of stuff if you can really overpack. The little refrigerator, I think, really will come in handy. Like I said, that little case right there, that little cabinet will go away that I've used for years just because I want something a little more compact and just makes more sense. So maybe I can sit it up there behind, strap it to the seat, but looks a little cleaner than that. But like I said, there's going to be a trifold foam pad on here. So I'm not sleeping on the wood with just a sleeping bag. Ouch. Lights, I have way more lights than that. I have another light that's magnetized. I have magnetized remote lights that I just are holding on in case I want to do an upgrade from this van at the beginning of next year and get a different one, a bigger one. So anyway, this is a Dodge Caravan, by the way, everyone. Platform came out fine, works, looks great, pretty sturdy. Just gonna add one little piece of wood to the bottom of the middle one just to make sure it's not off the ground, because I lifted the front of it to get rid of that slope that happens from the seats being down. Anyway, hope this helps everybody. And also I made sure it was tall enough to fit my toilet underneath it, just because if I had to use it or, you know, whatever, I always take it because you never know. I don't want to sit out in the middle of everywhere, you know? So anyway,
have a good day. Final note I just thought of too was,
I also have a little wooden crate that is about the size of a milk carton crate that I use also. And what I use it for, if I was cooking in the van, I would use it. I usually sit it about right in here and it sits maybe that tall. And so I'd use something like that. Of course, the seat would be pushed up, and actually I could put it out here or whatever I needed to do. I'd always be mindful of bedding and all that stuff. So, and I may push the cooler further on down, the refrigerator on down, just so when I'm stopped, I can hop right out of the front seat and hop in the back and not, and I can step over it, but you know, I don't want to step on it or, you know, kick it and everything else, you know, trying to get in the back. So it'll probably end up getting bumped back. And this right here, this seat back here does not have to stay up. It stows. And so I have plenty of room if I wanted to yank that and just drop it in the back. But I figured it'd be somewhere to sit. So that's why the only reason it's sitting. I would leave the seat up in the back was so I can actually sit down, because I can sit on the bed, but my head touches the ceiling. And I had to make it bed height just because I wanted to have enough storage space underneath the bed. So that's the benefit of having a seat if you just want to sit in the back and relax. And as you see, I do have a light back here, and I have plenty more than that that are